My name is Henry. I'm okay, but my Achilles heels are a bit hurt. So I might sit a little bit during this presentation. Okay, first of all, I'm very pleased that you're all here and proud, because competing with the beautiful weather outside and all the rings and bikinis, it's usually quite hard. It's quite the same as competing in the internet with the cat videos. That's usually quite difficult. Okay, so I think this is the second time I'm here. I had some friends in Otaniemi studying here, and we had nice parties here. It was not this building, it was the other building, but the parties were great. Okay, a little bit of background. I'm from Lappeenranta University. I studied finance there, and I have always had an interest in history. And history has been a big reason why I'm usually invested my time on investing. And one of the things which is very important to me has been the structure of time. That's not the case here. I'm not going to tell what is the structure of time. I'm just some info about my research and my background and what is the interest for me in the investing. In cryptocurrencies, I'm interested in the new opportunities and the possibilities. And if I see a market that usually in the stock market, if stock market moves, like it takes 5 to 10 years movements, that in a cryptocurrency market, it takes like a couple of weeks. So obviously there's a monetary interest as well, but the technology, that is the main purpose. I'm not the tech guy necessarily, but I study the market reactions of the, usually what happens about the certain cryptocurrency. Okay. There's a history of us generations before, and we always have to remember the generations before, because it's like a continuation process, accumulation of knowledge, and we have to be very thankful for the generations before, like baby boomers who were born in the 40s, and the next was the Generation X. They were born in the baby boomers were born in 40s and 60s, and the Generation X was after that. And I believe there are quite a lot of millennials who were born from early 80s to 90s. So there are different approaches how different people invest. And of course, the history and what has happened affects greatly on how we invest today. If I have done some consultation, legal consultation, and some financial consultation of the big guys there in the investing in Finland, and I was quite surprised, because back in the day when there was a commodity boom in the precious metals market, I was a student, and while I was interested in history, and I made some studies about gold and silver markets. Well, they hit the moon very quickly, but during the years, but the final year, 2011, it was like profits were like 100% almost for silver market. And I made a presentation for the one of the bigger investors, and they haven't heard about precious metals before. So I would encourage you usually to pay some attention about blockchain technology, because it could be in 6 months you know more than they will ever know. There's also a big proponent, a big thing in the technology side. We have to remember that baby boomers did not have access to technology. In many countries, like in Finland, we have the first regulation in the 80s in the stock market. But you guys are quite familiar with regulations already. That was not like before. It was like old saying that with baby boomers, they can drive a car, they can drive a plane, they can drive a jet or whatever, a rocket even. But we have the regulation, so we have to license, and that is a good thing. So, what about investing? Investing attitudes. of our younger generation. I believe I am in the Generation X and the middle of the Generation X and the and in the millennial. So I know a little bit about both worlds. That was like the time when the Generation Xers had a couple of crashes, and I know these people quite well. They had some bad experiences of the stock markets. Baby boomers had huge rise, and what I have learned from the bigger investors that they were usually invested only in stock markets, which is quite remarkable because we have heard about in the investing world diversification. They don't know about it still. And when it comes to the Generation X's, they have much better diversification. They much have a much better access to the markets, and they have a knowledge and a thirst to understand the markets. But when it comes to millennials, I have to say, millennials learn these things very fast. It takes like, if you watch a YouTube video, how to invest, and learn it in a couple of weeks, I think it's possible for all of you, because the tech is not the problem for you. You can find knowledge as well, so I think there's also huge possibilities in investing. I also encourage everyone to make their own decisions like there has been before. But if we think about easier strategies, how to invest in some cryptocurrencies, and when we compare cryptocurrencies to the stock markets, is it easier or is it harder? Well, the only thing what I have realized, I have noticed, is the speed. That is the speed. So if you are afraid of the crypto markets, don't be afraid. The tech will be solved in a couple of years maximum. So that is not going to be the problem. It is the speed at the moment, but that usually scares the bigger players, the older guys like Warren Buffett, which was mentioned before. Warren Buffett missed the dot-com bubble as well, but as we all know what happened after the dot-com bubble, everybody knows how to use computers, everybody. So what I encourage you to do is to trust yourself in the investing world. There's nothing new to you. It only requires three components, and those components are time, price, and the why. The why is the most important thing, because I encourage you to invest in a buy and hold strategy just because that is the way you learn how the market actually works. If you are there trying to make different things like, well, I have practiced and I do a research about turbo warrants and the fastest markets in the world, because I believe that you learn best when you fight with the bear. So that's the best way and quickest way to learn, because you need to survive there quickly. Okay. I don't have the memory sticks because that had an earlier summer vacation, but if you have any questions here, I would like to answer it right away. Yep.
So, okay, Rupert, can you hear me?
Yep.
So, I was just wondering about us policies. So, how many coins do you have? Or do you only invest in Bitcoin?
Yeah, good question. I don't really, I pay interest on few coins because the time is there, very important thing. I put the time limit usually in every day how much I pay attention to different markets. It's like 10 minutes maximum at the market. So I usually consider about 3 at the max. Sometimes I have considered paid attention on 50 coins at the same time, but that is too time consuming and you can't really make that much of progress. That's my experience of it.
So
take over of the crypto market as well, or what do you think of the situation there?
That's a very good question. I remember when the algorithm trading became more popular and there was lots of talks about manipulations in the market, and usually in every market there's a possibility of manipulation, so you don't really have to fear that. And the algorithm trading is quite funny because if somebody finds a flaw there, there's a possibility of quick gains also. So, but if I look at the algorithm and the past history prices of the certain cryptocurrencies, I don't really think that the algorithm trading is the problem there. Because if we look at the commodity markets, stock markets, it's just faster. The movements are just faster. In some coins, I don't say what those coins are, but they are those coins that no one should be investing. But you can see if the market is too unpredictable. You can see basically the chart has like this kind of moment is usually stable, but the movement are like this. If you see those patterns too often, I might stay away from those markets for a while. But I think the algorithm trading is part of it. It's just faster movements. Thanks. Yes? Good question. Well, I think they might have a... I'm not sure about it, but I believe they have an effect. One of the effects is that people will know the market, because futures market for investors is usually the normal place. And I think futures market is a very good thing for cryptocurrencies, because those investors who are not willing to invest in cryptocurrencies use futures. As there, they can see that the cryptocurrency world isn't that scary place.
So do you think that would also bring in the institutional investors coming in?
I think it could be a very important link there, too. Yep?
Do you still invest in another asset class or only in cryptos? So do you invest in commodities or precious metals? Or?
Good question. This is my advice, but I always encourage diversification. So I would not put all my money on cryptocurrencies. I would use stocks and also savings accounts and commodities as well. Diversification is very important. Unless you are, let's say, doing some business related to blockchain technology, crypto coins, then you have to be all in on your own project, of course.
Thank you, Henry.